Hi, hello, welcome back to my channel Twitter Things. Today in this video we are going to see like syntax of C# program. So you all know that we have started C# tutorials where we are going to discuss each thing, every concept which is present in C# in very in detailed manner with the examples through this website, which is W3Schools website, which is called as a first web developer website where you can learn each and every concept in detail, and we have a tried editor where you can try each examples at that particular instant only. So C# is a programming language which was developed by Microsoft on the .NET framework. It will run and it will be used to create web application, websites and desktop apps, mobile apps and games, and much more we can do with using C#. In the previous videos, we have seen how to create your first C# application, like console application on the .NET framework. We have seen either you can create it in the Visual Studio by installing that and setting up the .NET framework while installation, and also creating a console application. We have seen our C# first program. So also we have seen like how to create that in W3Schools website also, just by you can open tried editor and where you can write that code so that it will give the resultant outputs likewise. So we have seen that thing. So now let's see the syntax in that C#. Like in the previous video we have seen, like we have created program.cs file, right? So which is a .cs is nothing but C# file, that is a where we have .html, we called as that is a HTML file. Likewise, if .cs is the extension of that file, then we can say that particular file is related to C#, like kind of things. So program.cs is the file which is C# file which is used to print hello world on the screen, which we have seen in the previous video. We have created this example. So the result of this example is our hello world, is we get the output here. We have seen that in the tried yourself editor also. So whenever we change or edit the code in the tried editor, the resultant code will come there. So hi, we have seen there. When we run this particular code, you will get the resultant outputs in your output screen, that is console screen here. So let's see what this program is actually doing, how we are printing that particular thing, why we have written all these things here, what is the specialty of working of these all the things which we have written there in the program.cs file. Let's understand each and everything in detail. So this example I'm going to explain you, just listen carefully so that you will understand what the particular text we have written is actually mean. So without understanding that, how we can code likewise. So let's understand that particular thing. It's very important to understand that. So first line which we have is using system, right? Using system. So what is this using system? This using system means that we can use classes from the system namespace. System name, we have already some namespaces inbuilt in our particular thing. So when we use writing using system as your first line, your particular program, that means you are telling the compiler that you have to we are going to use that namespace, which is a system namespace, in our application. Like we can refer the classes present in that and the methods which are present in the classes which are present in the system namespace likewise. So we are referring that particular namespace in this particular application or in this particular namespace likewise. The first line using system means that we are using classes from the system namespace. The second line. Now the second line what we have is we have a blank line. So ignore that. C# ignores the white spaces. It doesn't bother like we have a empty line likewise. Just ignore that line. However, multiple lines make the code more readable. So if you maintain spaces that make separation, like so here we have using statements are completed, now we have started programming and this is the other method. So separation, giving multiple line separation will make the code as readable. So maintain that spacing if you are at like where we are divisioning, or if it is other part likewise, maintain, ignore the white space, maintain the black lines. I highly recommend you to like multiple lines makes the codes more readable. So go with it. So next, third line. So what we have is the third line is namespace hello world. So what is this namespace? actually namespace is a keyword which is used to organize your code, as it is a container for classes and other namespaces. So when we have this namespace, this is like used to organize your code, like to bundle the classes or to containerize the classes, like to group the classes, we use this namespace. If anyone namespace is present, so the below classes which are in that will be grouped, and we can call it as a single namespace. Like that we can do. If you want to refer all the classes present in particular namespace, then you can use that namespace in other applications, so that we can refer all the classes present in that particular namespace. Like that we can like it is just like a container for the classes, and other namespaces also we can include in one namespace. That thing also we can do. So that is the namespace, and we have to mention like namespace and name of that while you are defining that namespace. If you are using that namespace in any application, you have to write as the first line, as we discussed, like using system. Here system is also one of the namespace, so that will also create it at one point. So namespace is the can be created by using this keyword like namespace and name of that thing. So next, the fourth line which we have like a curly braces. So we have to open that namespace, right? The syntax we have to follow. Yeah, fourth line will be the braces, curly braces. You can see namespace open, and that braces will be end here. So what is this curly braces means? It's a block of code, likewise only. Like curly braces marks the beginning and ending of the block of code, like normal programming language, how we'll have curly braces, like in C, the similar kind of thing will present to tell that this particular code, like which is inside, we have coded related to this namespace, hello world, likewise. So that is a block of code for that namespace. And next, what we have after that is a class. So class is a container for data, methods. So which brings the functionality to your program. So why we have written this program, like to print something, to print in the console like this. So that programmability will present in this class. That is a class program. The name of the class here is program. So this the first keyword will be the class. So what this class will tell is, in that class we'll have maybe data or functions or methods we'll have in that particular class. So class is a container for data and methods, which brings the functionality to a program. Every line of code that runs in C# must be inside the class. If it is outside the class, that will not run. So whatever you have, your functionality, that should be included in the class only. So in our example, we have the name of the classes program. So class is the program. So whenever we have something, the name of that will be present followed by that. So class program. Don't worry if you don't understand how using system, namespace and class works. Just think of it as something that almost always appear in your program, and you will learn more about it in the later chapters. So whenever you see, try different example, you will understand, like you will get a habit of using all those things like this. So basically you should know these points, like why we are using namespaces to organize your code, that will have classes and other namespaces also. So namespace, and we'll start with curly braces and end with closing curly braces, and in that namespace we'll have classes. So that classes may be one or many. So class and followed by the class name, that may be program here. And in that classes, what we'll have, basically we have data and methods. Here method we have is a main method. So let's see that seventh line. So now class we have told. So class is opened and closing braces will be there for class, as we discussed how it is for namespaces. Another thing which appears in the C# program, that is main method. Any code inside it is in the curly braces will be executed. So main method we have told. So you don't know, understand the keywords before them, after main. So you will get to know little by little while learning this tutorial. So you can see, before main we have something like static, void. What are the things you don't know? So we'll learn in the upcoming video. Void is nothing but the return type. What is this method is returning? This method is not returning anything, so that is a void. So static means what static it is, like it's a static method, so no need to initialize that thing likewise. So you will understand those things in the upcoming videos. Let's see about method, that is main method. The name of that method is main. So next, what we have in the main method is some functionalities. Whatever the functionalities written in the method will got executed. So So main is the method which we don't need to call that thing. It will defaultly execute it as the first method. So console dot write line dot hello world. What is this console? So this console is the thing, but is a class which is present in system namespace. So it has a write line method. So now namespace is a method and console is the class and write name is the method that is used to print or output, give the output text likewise. So write line is the one method which is used to give the output or print the text. In our example, we are giving output as hello world text. We are printing that in our console. So if you omit this line, like using a system line in the first line, so you would have to use like system dot console dot write line. So if you write all these things, then it will be fine. So in the system namespace, in that console class, we have this, we are using this write line method. So this is the format we have to follow, syntax to follow if you are using this write line method which is present in console class, which is present in namespace. Where we are using this? We are using it in the namespace, hello world namespace. In the program class, we are using, in the main method, we are using this system.console.writeline. So note, CSharp statement ends with semicolon. So you have to understand this, like we have to use semicolon each and every session wherever we are ending that particular thing. Here you can see after read line they have used this semicolon, so you have to note that point first of all. Next is the point you have to remember is CSharp is case sensitive. Like it will have two definitions, if anything, like lowercase for uppercase. Like my class and normal lowercase my class are two different things. It has two different meanings here. So it will take us two different kind of things if there is a mismatch in the case sensitivity. So this is a case sensitivity. Like unlike Java, the name of the CSharp file doesn't have a match the class name. Like in Java, what we have to do, like program class name should match with the file name, but in CSharp it no need to match, doesn't have to match with that class name and file name likewise. But they often do for better organization, they will do such kind of things to understand better. Like program.cs file is the name of this file. Here you can see the class name is program. So for better understanding, we can prefer that, but it is not mandatory to go with the same name which has the file name which we have the class inside that file likewise. So when we are saving the file, we have to save it as a proper name. Like if it is a related program, you can give program.cs. You have to add that cs to the end of the file, that it is an extension. Like to run the example in our computer, you can make sure that CSharp is properly installed. So you have to install CSharp to run this program in your system. So or otherwise you can use W3Schools also, so that you can practice. You can also have exercises in this website so that you can practice and understand each and every concept in detail, and also try it yourself. Editor is there to alter the codes and execute by clicking on run. So this is the thing. You can write many more statements, not only single line, you can write multiple lines here. So hi, I can write on any text. Welcome, I can write. So if you are altering, you have to make sure you have clicked on run button, so that then only your outputs will come here according to your inputs which you are giving here. So hi, hello, welcome. So this is all about CSharp syntax. You have to follow this syntax every time you have writing a class and using other namespaces. You have to use using statement in the first line. You should follow this syntax only. You should not line by line you have to follow. You should not write using at last, or you should not like method first after namespace or all these things. You have to follow this particular syntax. First the files which you are using in that particular application, and after you have to give namespace for that. In that namespace you have to include our classes which we want. In that classes we'll have methods, and this is the syntax you have to follow for creating any CSharp application, like CSharp file. So that's all for this video. I think you got each and every thing detail, like basic thing which I think you are aware of to create your first CSharp program. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, give me a big thumbs up below. And if you have any doubts regarding this, like why we are using this particular thing, that particular thing, you can feel free to comment in the comment section. We will definitely reply to your comments and share this videos to your friends who are at learning stage of web development, like C# kind of things. So these videos will definitely help them because we are explaining everything in detail and with an examples and with the simple English. So these videos will definitely help them. Share these videos with them and subscribe to my channel for many more videos like this. And thanks for watching. Bye bye.